Do you hear that?
Yeah, I don't either, but it's making me feel creeped out.
Hey guys, Julia here for D News. The world is loud and noisy, and it only seems to be getting louder. Obviously, exposure to loud noises can cause hearing damage, but some studies, like one published in the British Medical Bulletin, show that it can cause a range of ill health effects like anxiety and stress, and another study showed it may even raise blood pressure. And that's just the sounds you can hear. There's a whole world of sound that's below our range of hearing that can also be damaging. Infrasound typically describes sound below 20 hertz. Usually, it's too low for humans to pick up, yet some animals communicate in this range. Like elephants vocalize in a low rumble that we can't hear. But infrasound can be artificial too. Loudspeakers and public address systems, industrial machinery, that kind of thing, can kick out sounds that are too low in frequency for humans to hear, but it might be making us sick. A study published in the journal Indoor and Built Environment found that infrasound could be contributing to a condition called sick building syndrome, a condition where office workers complain of nausea, dizziness, migraine, fatigue, and tinnitus with no attributable cause. Yet the study suggests that infrasound, typically of about 7 hertz, might be responsible. Unfortunately, infrasound isn't regulated all that well. A recent report in the Proceedings of the Royal Society A questions the idea of what makes up safe sound levels in a working environment. The report suggests that workplace exposure to both infrasound and ultrasound often exceeds current guidelines. There's concern, too, that the guidelines are too low and outdated, coming from research that's 40 years old. And even then, the evidence for the guidelines isn't strong enough. They are based on the average response of a small group, often of adult males. The researchers back then didn't reach any strong conclusions, just preliminary guidelines, believing that more research would be done. But in the ensuing decades, not much has changed. So basically, the lead author of this new report is saying more research is needed. But there is evidence that infrasounds cause more than just headaches. Some researchers think it might be responsible for that creepy, haunted house feeling. One paper published in the Journal of the Society for Psychical Research suggests that a standing sound wave of specifically 18.9 hertz is responsible for some of the spooky happenings in their lab. Researchers at Coventry University kept seeing moving things out of the corners of their eyes. Their hair kept standing on end. They felt simply dreadful anytime they were in the lab. But one day, they noticed a piece of equipment was vibrating without an apparent cause, and discovered that an extractor fan was creating a standing wave at, you guess it, 18.9 hertz. When they turned off the fan, one of the authors described the feeling as if a huge weight was lifted. And researchers have tested this idea on a larger audience, literally. British scientists played music to a large auditorium filled with people and slipped infrasound into some of their songs. Some people in the audience said they felt uneasy or sorrowful, getting chills down the spine or nervous feelings of revulsion or fear when the songs contained infrasound. Spooky, right? No, it's science. But don't be put off by sound waves yet. Not all of them are creepy. In fact, sound waves can do some pretty cool stuff. To learn more about how scientists are harnessing the power of sound, check out this episode right here.
If you gently flick a wine glass with your fingernail, you will hear its frequency. Match that tone and turn the volume up, way, way up to like 11, and that glass will probably break.
Test Tube now has a newsletter. Get a weekly roundup of our most popular videos across all of our shows at testtube.com/forward. So, have you ever gotten that creepy feeling or felt sick in your office or school for no reason? Do you think it might have been infrasound? Tell me your stories down below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to D News so you don't miss a single episode.